Guys, I'm going to be honest. I've just been sitting here staring at my TV for the past 24 hours, listening to these hot, hot jams. That's not true. I wish it was true. That would have been a better use of my time than whatever dumb BS I actually did. Pfft, work. I have jams to listen to. Speaking of jams, looks like Tat's about to get himself into quite a jam. Except not really. This boss is really easy.
I hope God won his battle.
I'm certain he did. He's become a very capable warrior.
You're right. Let's move on. It's time we finish this.
First, you abandoned your helpless friend to certain agony. Now you stumble to your doom.
We're tearing this place apart, brick by brick. Your time's running out, Necros.
Come to me then, like mindless moths to a flame. I'll take great care only to singe your wings before I crush your souls.
You won't stand a chance against me. My teacher was Muttonhead.
Muttonhead? Well, this will be more entertaining than I had hoped. Step forth, weakling!
Well, here goes nothing.
Good luck, Tat.
Man, why is he acting like Muttonhead is a super imposing figure? I mean, every time we dealt with Muttonhead, he seemed like 100% buffoon. Not 90% buffoon, 10% goon. Anyway, again, who is Necros? He's never been brought up before, and yet somehow we know exactly who he is. Apparently this is Necros, I guess? So yeah, this boss is a piece of cake. It's even easier than a piece of cake, it's a piece of pie. Pies are so much easier to make than cakes. Well, I haven't actually hit him yet, but... Okay. I'm holding up, so this... There we go. All you have to do is... Dodge that spark attack, and fire and hold up so that it seeks out that red orb thing that he's floating on. Yeah, that's literally all there is to this boss. Not that I'm complaining, mind you. It's kind of a welcome reprieve after Nutcracker version 2 and the thing that Gaul fought. Although the thing that Gaul fought wasn't that tough either, really. It's kind of going a little bit easy on you right before the final boss. The only real problem is that we can only deal 4 points of damage to him at a time, and that takes a little bit of time, but you know, could be much worse. Oh shit, I knocked his turban hat thing off. I bet that means things are about to get real, right? No, all that means is that that spark projectile thing moves a little faster, I think. That seems to be... I think it's moving a little bit faster, and there doesn't seem to be any other difference. So yeah, this is Necros' Super Saiyan form. I don't know what is this thing? It looks like half a robot. Super glued onto... actually, that red orb thing looks exactly like my trackball. I have one of those marble mice. It's like it's an optical trackball, and it has this red. It looks really cool, but mine's covered with little dots so that the optical sensor can track it better. But yeah, other than the little red dots, it looks exactly like that. Oh no, I got hit. What am I going to do? Although that does do a lot of damage. You can't take more than 2 or 3 of those. Crushed Necros. He sure did. Healing me. Not really.
Who has come before me disguised as a human? Only immortals wield such unbelievable power. I am finished. But you will never defeat the Overlord!
Mail should be at the Overlord's door by now. Luck be with you, Popful Mail.
Dang, the full name treatment. Alright, we have the last boss, guys. This is it. This is really, actually 100% it. No fooling. I'm really excited. I hope you are. Sorry for the short video. I do want to break this LP up into logical segments. You know, one video for each boss / event. And that, as piece of cake as I was, that does count as an event. So, tune in tomorrow around the same time. And, we have an Overlord to crush. See you guys then.